是
你是
but
however
然而
not
不是
不是
at my
own
my own
my own
我自己的
我自己的
anya
anya
other
other
别的
别的
street
street
woman
woman
女人
女人
garba
garba
womb
womb
子宫
子宫
sambretam
sambretam
born by
born by
由什么什么的出身
由什么什么的出身
However,
然而，
然而
，Veda,
Veda,
just try to know,
just try to know,
尝试着去理解，
尝试着去理解
，Bhavan,
Bhavan,
yourself,
yourself,
你自己，
你自己
，Yasya,
Yasya,
of which,
of which,
在什么之中，
在什么之中。
Durlabe,
Durlabe,
unapproachable,
unapproachable,
不可获得的，
不可获得的。
Arte,
Arte,
matter,
matter,
事情，
事情。
Manarata,
Manarata,
desirous,
desirous,
愿望，
愿望。
Translation, my dear child, you are unaware.That you were born not of my womb, but of another woman. Therefore, you should know that your attempt is doomed to failure. You are trying to fulfill a desire which is impossible to fulfill.
译文，我亲爱的孩子，你不知道你不是我生的，而是另一个女人生的。因此你应该知道你的努力注定会失败你在试图实现不可能实现的愿望那只不过是痴心妄想罢了
Purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada The small child Dhruva Maharaj was naturally affectionate towards his father and he did not know that there was a distinctionbetween his two mothers. This distinction was pointed out by Queen Suruchi, who informed him that since he was a child, he did not understand the distinction between the two queens. This is another statement of Queen Suruchi's pride.
要旨白石了跑不跑小孩子朱瓦马哈拉吉自然对他的父亲很有感情而且不知道他的两个母亲之间是有区别的王后苏如奇指出这一区别告诉朱瓦他是一个小孩子因此不明白两个王后之间的区别这是王后苏如奇骄傲地说出的另一番话
Om Magyanatimarandasya Gyananjana Salakaya Chatsuramilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tathati SwapadantikamVandeham Shri Guru Shri Yatapada Kamalam Shri Yurum Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sadrajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sabhadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya DevamShri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Nalita Shri Vishaka Nitamscha Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaste
Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasati Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
So we're hearing of this encounter between Dhruva Maharaj and his stepmother, Suruchi.
So we see this dialogue.
So, Dhruva Maharaj's father had these two wives, Suniti and Suruchi.
Dhruva Maharaj's father had two wives, Suniti and Suruchi.
Now, when a man is in the situation of having more than one wife, it's very important that they show equal respect for each other. That they have respect for each other.
通常情况下, 如果一个男子有两个妻子, 很重要的一点是他应该对两个妻子都保持相同的尊敬。
And particularly they should have nice respect for the children.
尤其是对他们的这个孩子要保持非常友好的尊敬。
Just like in the Ramayana, we hear about Maharaj Dasarath and his three wives. And they had four sons. There was Ram and Lakshman and Bharat and Shatrughna.
Bharat
and Shatrughna. So the four brothers were given equal affection by the three mothers.
他们这四个孩子, 被这三个母亲同等的对待。
And the children, like Lord Ram and Lakshman and Bharat and Shatrughna, they would show equal, they would consider each of the wives of their father to be like their mother.
他们四个母亲都是为相同的母亲，都是对于他们的父亲来说是平等的。Of
course, in the Vedas, it says we have is it six different mothers.
在这个伟达经中，我们讲了六个主要的母亲。We
should think of the earth like a mother.
我们应该视地球为母亲。The
cow is a mother.
奶牛是母亲。
The wife of the guru is the mother.
Guru 的妻子也是母亲.
And the wife of the king is also mother.
国王的妻子也是我们的母亲.
And some nurse who takes care of the children would think of the nurse also like a mother.
护士也是我们的母亲, 就像以前的奶妈一样.
So. This is a teaching of the Vedas to see all of these different personalities as a mother.
这是伟达经的教导，我们应该是这些人为我们的母亲。
We should respect the planet Earth, that Bhumi is also one of our mothers.
我们应该是这个地球为母亲，奶牛也是我们的母亲。
And the cows, taking care of the cows, people don't have any respect for the cows, they kill the mother.
现在的人们不尊重母亲，他们不尊重奶牛，他们杀奶牛甚至。
Just think how unfortunate this is, the world has become.
所以想一想这些，你就会发现这个世界是多么的不幸。
So here in this was long ago, in another yuga, in the pastimes of Dhruva Maharaj. And remember, Dhruva Maharaj's father, Uttanapada, he was one of the sons of Manu.
We know that Dhruva Maharaj's father, Uttanapada, he was 一个 Manu 的孩子。
Yeah, the first Manu in the day of Brahma, Swayambhuva Manu.
而且这是主 Brahma 的第一个 Manu, Swayambhuva Manu.
Manu means the father of mankind.
Manu 是人类的父亲。
So very important people in the society.
所以意味着是非常重要的人物。
And so Uttanapada had these two wives, but somehow this woman Saruchi had become polluted.
这些人非常重要，但是不知怎么的呢 ，Saruchi 她受到了污染。
Just like in Ramayana, we read about one of Lord Rama's wives, Kaikeyi.
就像我们读到的这个 Ramayana 罗摩衍那的这个逍遥时光中，我们读到了这个。
Kaikeyi, was it Kaikeyi? Yeah, Dasharatha's
wife.
Dasharatha's wife. I'm talking about Ramayana.
Kaikeyi 也是受到了污染。
She was the mother of Bharat.
她是巴尔塔的母亲。
All right. So Lord Rama's Maharaj Dasharatha was getting old, and he decided he wanted his oldest son.Lord Rama to become the king.
Dasharatha 王呢已经变老了，他希望他比较年长的儿子 Rama 继承王位。
And what was the name of Rama's mother?
Gosyalya.
Okay. So Gosyalya was the mother of Lord Rama. She was one of the wives of Dasharatha.
Gosyal 也是。
Gosyalya.
Gosyalya 也是。Rama 的，她是 Rama 的母亲，她是 Dasharatha 王的妻子，其中一位妻子。
Right, he had three wives.
他有三个妻子。
And so, this Bharat's mother Kaikeyi, she was given some bad advice by another woman.
这个 Kaikeyi 呢，由于受到了别的女人的一个非常不好的建议。
What was the name of the maid servant?
Mantara.
There was a lady, she was quite evil-minded woman who was single woman who was working in the palace there. Her name was Mantara.
这个在宫殿里面有一个女仆叫 Mantara， 她呢是一个非常卑微的，然后是一个。单身的女仆。
So she came to Kaikeyi, and she told Kaikeyi.
她到这个凯凯伊面前开始说话。
She said, "This is very bad news. If Rama will become the king, this is not good."
如果 Rama 继承了王位，成为了国王的话，这将是一个非常不好的消息。
Actually, everybody loved Rama.
事实上，每个人都喜欢 Rama。
And Kaikeyi also loved Rama until she heard this woman Mantara speak.
直到她听这个仆人在说这番话之前，她也非常喜欢 Rama。
But then she heard from Mantara.
但当她听了 Mantara 的一番话之后
，And Mantara was putting poison into her mind.
她把一些毒药倒到了她的内心。
And she told her that.If Ram will become the king, then your son Bharat will have no position.
如果 Rama 成为了国王，你的儿子 Bharat 将一无所有，没有位置。
He will not be given any respect.
他不会得到任何的尊重。
Your son Bharat should become the king.
而你的儿子 Bharat 他应该成为国王。
And if he becomes the king.Then you're the mother of the king. It will be very good for you.
如果你的儿子成为了国王，那么呢，你将是王的这个母亲。
But if Ram becomes a king, then his mother will be given more importance, more respect.
如果呢是 Rama 的母亲成为了这个，如果是 Rama 成为了国王，那么呢 ，Rama 的母亲将会得到更多的尊重。
So.We should arrange to have your son become the king.
我们应该安排你的儿子巴尔塔成为国王。
But Kaikeyi was thinking, well, how to do it?
然后凯凯伊就开始思考，怎么样达到这个事情呢？
So then Mantara knew that before, in the past, somehow Kaikeyi had been given a boon by her husband. She'd been offered a benediction from her husband.
这个 Mantara 呢，知道凯凯伊在很久以前呢，她能够，她得到了她丈夫的一个祝福。一个 许诺
She rendered very special service to her husband. She helped him in a very difficult situation.
在一个很特别的情况下，在凯凯伊呢，当时呢救了这个国王一命。
So her husband was very grateful.
她的丈夫对她因此非常感恩。
And he told her, "Please ask for something. What can I do to repay you?"
然后呢，她的丈夫说，请你向我说一些你的愿望，让我来回报你。
But she said, "No, I don't want anything."
然后他的妻子就说，没关系，我不要任何事情。
But he said, "All right, you don't need anything now. In the future, when you need anything, then you can come and you can take two benedictions from me."
然后他的这个丈夫就说，如果呢，你现在不要没有关系，等以后呢，想起来你就告诉我，以后呢，我给你两个祝福。两个许诺，两个愿望。
So this poison was put into the mind of this other wife of the king.
然后呢，这个毒药呢就进入到他们的内心之中。
So Ram was to become the king the next day.
第二天 ，Rama 就要成为国王了。
But Kaikeyi went to see her husband.The night before,
凯凯伊就在前一天的晚上到达了国王的这个面前。
Oh no, she didn't go to see the king. What happened was she went into mourning, and she had a special room where the woman could go when she's not feeling very peaceful or in a good mind.
她是在第二天的早上去的，然后呢，她当时表现出一个非常不舒服的这个状态。
So she had a special room where she could go.
她有一个很特别的房间。
When she's not in good mood.
就是当她心情不好的时候，她会去那个房间。
So her husband heard that Maharaj Dasarath, the king, he heard that Kaikeyi has gone into this room. She's not well. She's not in a good mood.
当这个 Dasarath 的王听到这个消息之后呢？听到他去那个房间之后呢，知道他不好之后
，So he came to see her.
然后他就去看望她。
Came to see my dear wife. What is wrong? What can I do to make you happy?
我亲爱的妻子，我应该做什么能让你高兴
？And she was laying on the ground with her hair all untied, and she was looking very miserable.
她的头发披散着，然后看上去非常憔悴。
And her husband was saying to her, "What can I give you to make you happy? What can I do for you?"
她的丈夫就问，我应该给一些什么？我也可以为你做一些什么，能让你快乐起来。
So then she said, "Yes. Do you remember that time you told me you would give me benedictions?"
你还记得当初你给我的这个许诺，可以达成我的愿望吗？
He said, "Yes." He said, "What do you want? Tell me. I'll be happy to fulfill your mind."
当然记得，你告诉我什么事情能够让你高兴。
So she said, "Now you've promised, you have to keep your promise."
那么呢，你现在得记住你的承诺。
So then she told her, "I want that Ram should go to the forest to live in the forest for 12 years."
我现在呢，希望 Rama 去到森林待上十二年。
So when Maharaj, when the king heard this, and he fainted, he fell on the floor.
当这个Maharaj, 当这个国王听到这个消息之后，他马上倒下。
And then she said, "Second thing is, I want my son Bharat should become the king."
然后他要的第二个祝福是，我希望我的儿子巴尔塔他成为国王。
So the Maharaj Dasarath, he was the king. He had made up. He was vowed to. Never tell a lie.
这个 Maharaj 这个国王呢，他发下了一个誓言，这个誓言呢，就是他永远不说谎。
He said, better I would die than have to tell a lie.
如果我要说谎的话，还不如死去更得。
So he had to keep his promise.
所以他得维持他的承诺。
And he had to send Ram to tell Ram that I don't want you to become the king today. Instead, I want you to go and live in the forest.
然后他就跟 Rama 说了这一番话。
How many years? 14 years? For 14 years.
他让 Rama 去森林游放了十四年，今天你就不能当国王了，去森林待上十四年。
Yeah, and Bharat will become the king.
然后呢 ，Bharat 将成为国王。
Of course, when Bharat got the news of this, I'm not going to become the king. I'm not going to do this. Ram should be the king.
当 Bharat 听到这个事情之后，我不想成为国王 ，Rama 应该成为国王。
Good.A similar kind of situation to what happened here with Dhruva Maharaj.
在这里也有同样相同的这个事情发生在朱瓦马哈拉吉的身上。
We don't know where Suruchi got this poison from.
我们不知道这个 Suruchi 是从哪里喝下得到的这个毒药。
In the Ramayana, it tells about Kaikeyi that this maidservant Mantara, she put the poison into the mind.
在这个Ramayana 这个逍遥时光中呢，我们知道是Mantala 他把这个毒药倒给了Kaikeyi的心中。
But we don't know here about Suruchi. Why Suruchi's got this evil thought?
我们不知道在这个逍遥时光中 ，Suruchi 他是怎么样知道的？他是怎么内心被有这么恶魔的这个想法
？It may just simply be due to her own pride.
有可能呢，就是来自于他内心的这个骄傲。
That she's proud of being the favorite wife of her husband.
她认为呢，她是她丈夫的非常宠爱的妻子。
And she wants to take advantage of her position.
她就利用这个职位，利用这个位置做一些事情。
But Dhruva Maharaj, as a young child.He thinks that Suruchi and Suniti are both his mother.
Dhruva Maharaj 呢认为 ，Dhruva Maharaj 他是这么想，他认为 Suniti 和 Suruchi 都是他的母亲。
This is, and according to the scriptures, according to the prophet, they're both ladies, both the wives of his father, so they're both like his mother.
他认为这两个妻子，这两个女士都是他丈，都是他父亲的妻子，所以呢，都是他的母亲。
But Suruchi is saying, "You're not born from my womb."
但是呢 ，Suruchi 竟然说，你不是从我的子宫里出生的。
So your life is not very good.
你的生命并不好，你的出生并不好。
You have to be born from my womb.
除非你从我的子宫里诞生。
Then you can be the real son of your father.
那么呢，你才可以成为你父亲真正的儿子。
So you see this kind of pride in people of demonic nature who are influenced by passion and ignorance.
所以你看到这样的一些人，他被这个激情属性严重的影响。
Just like in the pastimes of Prahlad Maharaj, we hear about Prahlad's father.
我们看到这个 Prahlad Maharaj 的逍遥时光，他的父亲。
Prahlad's father was always making a distinction between the friends and the enemies.
他的父亲总是对朋友和敌人做出区分。
And he was always telling Prahlad Maharaj.Go to school and learn how to deal with the enemy.
他总是希望他的孩子 Prahlad Maharaj 去到学校学习如何跟这些敌人相处。
But Prahlad Maharaj had already heard from Narada Muni.
但是呢 ，Prahlad Maharaj 从 Narada Muni 那里听到了一些话，学习。
When he was still within the womb of his mother, he had heard from Narada Muni.
当他还在他母亲的子宫的时候，他就开始聆听， Narada Muni 的话语。
And Narada Muni had been telling Prahlad to see everybody equal.
Narada Muni 告诉 Prahlad Maharaj 应该平等的对待。
Don't make distinction between friends and enemies.
不要对敌人和朋友做出区分。
So Prahlad Maharaj was telling his father.
His father, Hiranyakashipu, would ask Prahlad,
"What did you learn from your teachers?"
那个黑人卡西普就问这个卡拉的，问他的儿子，你从学校那里学到了什么
？And Prahlad would say, he would talk about that if one is in the bodily consciousness of life, he's like an animal in the bottom of a well.
如果一个人有躯体化的这个概念的话，他的生命
，like an animal，
他生命就像一个动物一样。
In the bottom of a well，
bottom of
the bottom of a well， 金色，它掉小在一个金色的地下，
就像一个金子掉在地上。
对，在地下，那金子 get the water from the well， 你那个水从。一个金出来的，所以一个动物掉下进去那个钉子，他们没办法出来，啊？你明白吗？
不是，
一个动物，他们走路的时候，他们不知道。
掉在一个陷阱里面。
哦，就像一个动物掉在这个陷阱里面一样。
There's a well，
是一个井。
And the animal falls in the well.
就像这个动物掉在这个井里面一样，就是这好比人像一个动物，而且这个动物掉在这个井里面。
So the animal falls in the well cannot get out.
这个动物掉在井里面是不可能爬出来的。
No way the animal can find to get out. It's a helpless condition.
这是一种非常无助的情况。
So.Somebody in the bodily concept of life is like that.
如果人有躯体化的这个概念，就像这样一种情况。
And Prahlad Maharaj would say, the only hope is to go to the forest.
而唯一的希望是一个人应该去森林。
You have to renounce.
你应该弃绝。
Renounce the material life.
弃绝这个物质化的生活。
And go into the forest and do austerity.
然后去到森林从事苦行。
Good. You live in the forest. It's quite austere.
当然，在森林里面是非常苦行的。
There's no supermarkets.
那里没有超市。
Right. You just eat the wild leaves and the wild fruits.
你只是吃一些叶子和这个水果。
Drink the water from the stream.
然后呢，喝一些瀑布那里流出来的水。
Lay on the ground.
然后躺在地上，草地上。
So, going into the forest means to accept some austerity.
去到森林意味着接受一些苦行。
But that is very purifying.
但是呢，这种苦行也会很净化。
And takes one out, quickly you can get freed from the bodily conception.
能够帮助一个人很快的从躯体化的概念之中走出来。
Prahlad's father would be telling him, he wanted his son to distinguish who is a friend and who is the enemy.
这个 Prahlad Maharaj 的父亲 Hiranyakashipu 希望他的儿子能够对敌人和朋友做出区分。
And how to deal with the enemy?
怎么去处理这些敌人
？So the teachers in the Gurukula they were teaching Prahlad how to deal with the enemy.
在他们那里的这个学校古鲁库拉里面的老师教你怎么样去处理这些敌人。
First of all, you try to speak to them nicely and convince them to be on your side.
首先呢，你得说服你的敌人能够站到你这一边。
If they won't listen to your advice, then you try to bribe them.
如果呢，他能够听你的话，站到你这边，你就表扬他。
You offer them some money or some position that if you join me and work with me and follow my instructions, then I'll give you this.
如果你接受我的建议，站到我这一边的话呢，我就给你提供一些地位，给你一些钱等等。
But if they won't agree, then you may have to fight. You may have to put them in jail and punish them.
如果呢你不站到我这一边，我就把你关到监狱里面去。
You may even have to end up killing them.
甚至要把你杀死。
So politics is like this.
这些政客们都是这样的。
When people are engaged in political activities, they have to deal with their enemies.
当这些政治上的人他想到达一定地位的时候，他必须处理他的敌人。
People who have a different idea, then you have to think how to deal with them.
当如果有人跟你的意见不同的时候，你得小心的怎么样跟他相处。
But Prahlad was saying, no, Father, no, we don't need to do this. We just see everybody equally.
他然后反驳他的父亲说，父亲。不必这样，我们应该看每个人都是同样的。
Everyone is a spirit soul.
每个人都是灵性的灵魂。
We don't want to make distinction, friends and enemies. See everybody equally.
我们不应该做出区分，应该平等的对待每一个人。
So, we see, Suruchi, she doesn't have that kind of vision.
Suruchi 呢，她没有这样的视野。
Dhruva Maharaj, because he's innocent, a young child, he doesn't make distinction.
但是朱瓦马拉吉在他很小的时候，他是这样平等的，有这样的视力。
Young child is born, and there are ladies in the house. All the ladies will take care of the child.
这个小孩出生的时候，所有的母亲都照顾这个小孩，所有的女士。
All the ladies would.They like children and they take up the child and hold the child in their arms.
这些女士就把这个小孩给抱起来，关爱他。
So the child does not understand. Doesn't think one is my mother, one is not my mother.
这个小孩呢，在这受到这样的对待之后，他不会想哦，这个是我的母亲，那个不是我的亲生母亲。
I think they're all my mothers.
他会认为所有的都是我的母亲。
Of course, Vedic culture is that we address all ladies except one's own wife as mother.
所有呢，在伟大经中有这么一个教导，一个人应该是所有的女士都为自己的母亲，除了自己的妻子之外。
We address the other mothers.
我们称所有的女士为 Mataji.
So, it means we respect all the other ladies like our mother.
这就意味着我们尊敬所有的人为我们的母亲。
But modern society has become in a different way.
但是呢，现在生活是另外一种情况。
They say today that men and women are equal.
现在人们都提倡男的和女的是一样的。
So men and women both have to work.
所以呢，男的和女的都应该去工作。
But of course, it's only women who have to give the children, give birth to the child.
但是呢，你又会发现只有女的可以生孩子。
Men cannot give birth to children.
男的是不可以生孩子的。
So men take advantage of women.
所以呢，其实是男的在利用女人。
Let the women go out to work.
他让女的去工作。
So trying to, we want to see people. We have to understand the nature of the physical body.
我们应该了解这个物质躯体的本性。
According to the particular body, people have to be given.
在不同的这个躯体之中，人们应该得到尊敬。
Of course, we see Prahlad Maharaj was saying, see everybody equal. It doesn't mean you treat everybody equally.
Prahlad Maharaj 看每个人是平等的，但并不意味着我们对待每个人是一样的。
We see everyone as a spirit soul.
我们看每个人是平等的灵魂。
But the bodies are different.
但是呢，他们的躯体是不一样的。
Just like we deal with human beings in a different way from how we deal with animals.
就像我们对待人类和对待动物是不一样。
You know, we see also the soul in the dog, but we don't bring dogs into the temple.
我们能够在狗里面也看到这个灵魂，但是我们不把狗带到庙里面去。
We like animals. We have various. We you know we treat them with also. We give them also the mercy. We try to help them also progress.
我们也帮助这些狗，也给这些狗爱心，给他们提升的这个机会。
Today people are they say they love dogs, but at the same time they kill cows.
当今的人们呢，他说我很爱狗，但是呢，他又开始杀牛。
I was in Hong Kong, and the one lady came, and she was telling me she was donating for the homeless dogs.
我在香港的时候，有一个女士告诉我说，她说她给一些流浪狗做布施，做捐款。
And she even kept several dogs in her home.
她还养了七条狗在她的家里面。
So I told her, I said,What about cows? What do you think about cows?
然后我就问这个女士，你怎么样看待奶牛呢？奶牛怎么办呢？
She said, I never thought about cows.
这个女士就说，我从来没有考虑过奶牛。
But we see people everywhere, you know, they have these, they eat these burgers, and they have different advertisements where they show cows.And they show them in the fields, and they draw pictures of cows looking very happy.
我们看到人们一边又去吃各种各样的汉堡，一边又去杀这些牛。
You know, if you look at these places, these big chains, like they have these chains, big, they have these, what's it, McDonald's. You know, their places look very nice and everything, you know.
我们看到这个杀牛的，这个比如说麦当劳，它会有一个汉堡，汉堡呢旁边还有一些照片，可能描述的是这些牛住在一个非常美丽的环境中。
And they make a nice environment for the children to come and want to come there and play.
他们描述一个很好的环境，还说。我们的这个有很多小孩来到这个美丽的环境，和这些动物和平共处。
But they don't show you what they do to make these burgers.
但他们从来不会向你展示他是如何做这些汉堡的。
How they kill these cows?
他们是如何杀这些奶牛的
？How in the most cruel, the most horrible way they butcher the cows?
他们非常恐。非常糟糕的、非常邪恶的这个手段杀这个奶牛。
Yeah, anybody who would go to see how they kill these animals, you would just cry. It's so horrible.
任何人只要能看到他们去如何杀这些奶牛的，一定会哭的。这个场景实在是太恐怖了。
But every day they're killing millions.
但是呢，每一天。他们都能杀上成百万的奶牛。
And people don't even think about it.
但是呢，人们从来没有考虑过这个事情。
They don't think, oh, this is our mother.
他们不会认为这个奶牛竟然是我们的母亲。
But we all drink milk.
但是我们每一个人都在喝牛奶。
We want the cow's milk. We need the milk for the health of the body.
我们都需要牛奶，为了身体健康。
And the planet belongs to the cows. Bumi, the deity of this planet is a cow.
这个 Bumi 的这个神像也属于奶牛。
Yeah, she's a cow. Bumi is a cow.
Bumi 也是一个奶牛。
She's this planet belongs to the cows.
这个星球属于奶牛。
But the cows are domestic creatures. They need to be taken care of.
但是呢，这个奶牛需要被很好的照顾。
They're meant to be taken care of. They're meant to be taken care of by humans.
它应该受到人类很好的照顾。
We need the cows because the milk is so important for our health.
我们需要奶牛，因为奶牛的这个牛奶对于我们人体身体健康很重要。
If you don't get milk, then you don't develop a good brain.
如果我们没有牛奶，我们的大脑发育可能不是特别好。
You won't be able to understand this knowledge of Krishna consciousness.
我们甚至不能理解这个 Krishna 知觉的这个经典。
So, taking care of, protecting the cows is a part of civilized society.
保护奶牛也是这个文明的一部分。
But we don't care about cows anymore.
但是呢，我们现在已经没有那么的在意奶牛了。
We have cars, petrol.
我们有这个汽车，汽油。
We have our so many other things. We don't think about the situation of the animals.
我们不再那么考虑这些动物们的处境。
So long as we're comfortable, so long as we're happy, why care about the cows?
只要我现在活得还挺不错的，只要我现在还挺快乐的，我为什么要去考虑这些奶牛呢？
But the cows are mother.
但是这些奶牛是我们的母亲。
So here also, Dhruva Maharaj sees the two ladies as his mother.
朱阿玛拉吉看他的两个母亲，看这两个女士都为自己的母亲。
But Suruchi is telling him, No, you're not my son.
但是 Suruchi 说，不，你不是我的儿子。
She has become polluted by pride.
她被她的骄傲所污染了。
So this is a very deadly thing. Pride is something very, very bad for all of us.
这是对我们每个人都非常不好的事情。
How can we avoid becoming proud?
如何去避免这种骄傲呢？
We learn by taking up Krishna consciousness.
我们通过学习 Krishna 知觉。
Right? We learn to bow down before superiors.
我们学习在这个权威面前，神像面前顶拜。
Respecting the mother and the father.
尊敬父亲和母亲。
Respecting superiors.
尊敬这些神圣的东西。
That helps to make us humble.
这会让我们变得谦卑。
This is austerity of the body.
这是身体上的苦行。
An austerity of the mind is to be satisfied in every situation.
对于心意的苦行意味着我们应该在任何情况下都感到满足。
To cultivate the mode of goodness, we have to learn to be satisfied.
如果你想培养一个善良品性的话，你应该学会自足。
Satisfied with our material situation.
对这个物质的处境感到满足。
The more we are anxious for improving our condition, then we lose our austerity.
我们越是焦虑的想要提升我们的物质处境，我们就越会失去我们苦行的品质。
Austerity is one of the pillars of religion.
苦行也是宗教的一个支柱之一。
So we have to cultivate this austerity.
我们应该培养我们的苦行的品质。
An austerity of words, we said we described yesterday, speaking the truth, pleasing in a pleasing way.
昨天呢，我们也讲了苦行在言语上的苦行，意味着我们说真话。同时能取悦他人的话
，and reciting the Vedas, reciting scripture，
然后用我们的言语去朗诵经典
，offering prayers，
敬献祷文。
These activities help us to cultivate humility, to give up pride.
这些活动能够帮助我们放弃骄傲，培养谦卑。
Just like yesterday, we went for Sankirtan.
就像我们昨天去做Sankirtan,
that also helps to make us humble.
这也能让我们变得谦卑.
We go and chant the holy name for the benefit of the conditioned souls.
我们出去唱诵是为了这些受条件限制的灵魂, 他们的益处.
We're chanting and dancing for the satisfaction of Lord Krishna.
我们唱诵跳舞是为了Krishna的快乐和满足.
Because we know this activity of Sankirtan is pleasing to Krishna.
因为我们知道这些活动能够取悦Krishna.
500 years ago, when Lord Chaitanya was here, every day he would go for Sankirtan.
500年前主柴太娘来的时候, 每一天他都去Sankirtan.
And he did this chanting of the holy name to everyone.
他把这个唱诵带给每一个人。
So we want to cultivate these kind of qualities.
我们应该学习培养这些品质。
Will help us to become free of pride.
然后呢, 能够去除我们免除这些骄傲。
And we can avoid these dangerous situations.
我们也能避免这些非常危险的处境。
Okay, any questions?
请问大家有问题吗?
Comments?
评论?
May I ask my question? We talked about the milk, I think. Some people say the milk we have today is also very produced in a very horrible way, how they inject the cows with the hormones. So, the milk, it's also product of violence, they say. So, should we also take that milk, or should we, how can we take it?
Yeah. 这个帕布问就是有一些牛奶的奶牛可能受到一些非常糟糕的处境，那么呢，我们是不是应该喝这些牛奶？
Yes, actually, the milk which you get in places like 7-Eleven or supermarkets is not actually very good milk.
事实上，在这个 7-Eleven这些超市啊。 得到的这些牛奶并不是特别好的牛奶。
It's not ahimsa milk.
这个不是非暴力的牛奶。
Right, if you want ahimsa milk, you have to get milk from cows which are taken care of by devotees.
如果你想喝一些 ahimsa 非暴力的牛奶的话，你最好从奉献者那里，因为这些奶牛能够得到奉献者的照顾，他们给你的牛奶。
The devotees take care of the cows, and even after the cow can no longer give milk, they will still continue to protect and maintain the cow.
奉献者对待奶牛的方式是，这个奶牛即便它不能给你提供牛奶了，奉献者依然照顾这个奶牛。
But in the material society, as soon as the cow no longer gives milk, they will kill it.
但是这个现代化的生活呢？ 现代的这个世界, 当这个奶牛不能提供牛奶的时候, 人们就杀掉它。
And they will kill it in the most brutal manner. The most horrible manner.
他们又非常恐邪恶的一些人。
So when we buy their milk, then we are encouraging them to exploit and take unfair advantage of the cow.
所以当我们去买这些奶牛的时候，也是在鼓励他们这么的一些行为，非常邪恶的一些行为。
And then of course people also, they use a lot of animal skin, the leather from the cow. They use that for shoes and for belts and for covers, seat covers of the car and so on.
然后呢，现在的一些人们杀掉奶牛之后，还用这个牛皮做什么汽车的这些垫子啊，还有鞋子啊，等等一些。
So people
they don't have, they don't realize how the cow is such a special animal that when they are killing a cow, it's almost like killing a person.
杀一个奶牛意味着你杀了一个人，但是人们并没有意识到这一点。So
we're trying to educate people about the importance of cows and how to and protecting cows.
我们应该试着能够给予别人一些知识和教育别人。 如何保护奶牛?
Actually, we should have our own cows.
事实上，我们应该有自己的奶牛。
If we want to drink milk, you should have your better. You should have your own cow.
如果你想喝奶牛的，喝牛奶的话，你应该有自己的奶牛。
You have one cow, and then every year, the cow can have one calf.
Calf.
小牛。哦，当这个。
奶牛，你有一头奶牛的话，每一年的时候，你都会有一头小牛。
And every day you get milk. 每一天你都会有牛奶。Well, you can use a bull to do things like plow the field.
你可以让这个公牛去耕地。And
they use a bull also to pull, they can, to transport things from one place to another and move people from one place to another.
你也可以让这个公牛承载，就是载你去一个地方，从一个地方到另外一个地方。
Instead of having a bao shi jie, you can have a宝马。
比起你开宝马，你可以有一头公牛。
Instead of having a fancy car, you can have a. That's right. Instead of having a Porsche, you can have a bullock car. Prabhupada told us this modern world, modern society is doomed to failure.
圣帕帕德告诉我们，这个现代的这个文明社会迟早是会失败的。
This petrol is not going to last forever.
这个汽油不会永远的提供给我们。
Look what it has done to the planet. This petrol has polluted so many places.
你们看一看这个汽油、石油，对这个地球造成了多么大的污染。
But if you have cows and bulls, they just give dung. The cow dung. It's very purifying for everything.
所以你看这些奶牛、公牛也好，它们只是产一些牛粪，而这些牛粪对于我们又是很净化的。It's
so useful, so valuable thing.
又是非常有价值的，非常有价值的事情，有价值的东西。But
we're taking the petrol, we're taking the oil and burning it, and we're getting so much bad things, so many horrible things.
但是呢，我们用这个汽油。 去燃烧之后得到的全都是不好的东西。
And we're also upsetting the position of the planet, the orbit of the planet.
然后这个城市生活呢，也是非常糟糕的处境。Srimad
Bhagavatam describes about Hiranyaksha, that because he was taking gold everywhere, and so the earth fell into the bottom of the Garbhodaika ocean.
这个圣帕帕的在这个圣典佛教宝坛里面有讲，黑人亚克沙这个恶魔，他由于把地球的这个黄金都偷走了，所以呢，这个地球失重，最后又落到了这个海洋之中。So
the more we're taking out the oil from the ground, the more chance there is of this earth planet falling into the bottom of the Garbhodaika ocean again.
我们如越多的从这个地球攫取这个石油，越有可能也会造成当初的这种失重的情况下，最后掉到甘波达沙伊，为什么这个洋海洋之中
？But there's no problem to have a lot of cows and bulls.
但是呢，如果有奶牛和公牛的话，不会有这样的问题。
Everything from the cows useful.
任何从奶牛身上出来的东西都是有用的。
The cow urine, the cow stool, everything.
牛尿、牛粪，所有的一切都有用。
Subsidiary vows or things like that. So in that particular situation, should he have not, you know, just considered the pleasure of Lord Ram to be superior than his own vow? How do we understand this situation? Because very often, as devotees, we are told, you know, we have to do for the pleasure of Krishna. We are. Yeah.
他是不是问这个我们到底应该是弃绝呢，还是把一切用来服务 Krishna？
So, he's asking about this in relation to Maharaj Dasarath, Lord Rama's father. That Lord Rama's father, I said he had a vow to be truthful,
yes,
and not to break his promise.
Yeah.
But Antaranga Prabhu is quoting the Bhagavad Gita that Krishna says, give up religious principles and just surrender to him.
Okay. 这个Prabhu 问的这个问题呢，达萨拉达他有一个誓言，就是永远不要说谎话，比起说谎话还不如让我去死去。那么呢，帕布又同时引用了博迦梵歌中的一个诗节，Krishna 告诉阿尔朱那说，抛弃一切种类的宗教，一切职责，只是向我皈依。
So Krishna says, give up all religious principles and just surrender to me.
Krishna 给出的这个建议是抛弃一切种类的宗教，只向我皈依。
This means give up all religious principles which are based on material motivation.
这个意味着我们抛弃的是一切种类的基于物质利益的欲望和宗教。
Maharaj Dasarath is a great devotee of the Lord.
Maharaj Dasarath, he actually is a great devotee.
So his vow of being truthful, it wasn't something which he was performing just for his own name and sake.
而 Maharaj Dasarath, 他发下的这个誓言，保持说真话，他不是为了展现自己的个人这个风采，或者说一种自我展现。他不是为了个人的利益。
He had these qualities of he was a very saintly person. It was just his nature to be honest.
从他的品质上来讲，他也是非常圣洁的，而且是一个非常神圣的品性。
And we have to understand that the Lord has come, that the Chaturvyuha all came as the sons of Maharaj Dasarath.
我们知道这个 Dasarath 其他的这些儿子也来了。
Vasudev, Sankarshan, Aniruddha and Pradyumna, they are the four brothers, the four sons of Maharaj Dasarath.
Dasarath 还有这个四个儿子，这个 Aniruddha,
Vasudev, Sankarshan,
Vasudeva, Sankarshan, 他们都是 Dasarath 的儿子。
Right. So they're all incarnations of the Lord.
他们都是主的这个化身。
And they've come to perform particular pastimes.
他们来的是为了展现一种特别的逍遥时光。
So Lord Ramachandra he has to go through this lila.
So Ramachandra
Maharaj Dantaras, although he had to go through this lila, this was his lila with Lord Ramachandra. It was the arrangement of the Lord.
这是主的一种安排.
So Maharaj Dasarath is not going to break his promise because he is under the control of Yokamaya, right? He doesn't think of Lord Rama as being the personality of Godhead. He just thinks he's my son.
这个Ramachandra呢，他也是一个圣洁的人，他能够控制心意，但是呢，他也被这个Yogamaya所控制。他认为主Rama只是他的一个儿子。
Doesn't think he's God.
他没有认为他是主。
So he's not going to change it, he's not going to lie, he's not going to break his promise just to keep his son with him at home.
所以呢，基于他没有认为他是这个主，所以他也不想打破他的这个誓言。
We cannot say, oh, for Krishna we can do anything.
我们不能说为了Krishna我可以做任何的事情。
We can lie, cheat, and steal.
我们可以为了Krishna去说谎、欺骗，然后去偷东西。
When the devotees first came to Vrindavan,
有一些奉献者第一次到Vrindavan的时候,
they would go and take sweets out of the sweet shop.
他也去一些甜品店偷东西。
And they wouldn't pay for them.
然后呢，去拿了这些甜品之后不给钱。
So they came and told Prabhupada, the Prabhupada, your disciples are taking everything, taking all of our sweets without paying anything.
然后这些店长呢，就到帕帕来去说，你的这些门徒到我这儿拿了这些甜点，也不给钱。
And Prabhupada asked the devotee, what happened? The devotee said, but Prabhupada, you said it's all prasadam in
Vrindavan.
So we thought, it's all prasadam, why we pay for it?
既然是普沙的，我们为什么要给钱呢？
So Prabhupada had to instruct them, you know, this. You know, you can't do like that. You can't just go and take food from all the shops. It's not proper. It's just not right.
然后帕帕就教育他们，你们不应该到这些店里面去做这样的这些事情。
So sometimes we think, you know, for Krishna, Krishna says, you know, give up all religious principles. We can do anything for Krishna.
有些人就利用这句话，我可以为Krishna。 我们把所有的一切献给 Krishna， 我们可以为 Krishna 去做任何事情。
But we do it. We don't do it for Krishna. We do it for our sense grasp.
但是事实上，这个时候我们不是为 Krishna 在做，而是我们在为自己做，为自己的感官享受在做。
So we have to want to do everything for Krishna.
我们应该真的考虑去如何一切为了 Krishna。
So Maharaj Dasarath, he's under the control of Yogamaya, he's thinking his son, you know, his son, he doesn't want his son to go, but he's no choice in the matter. The lila has to be performed. The pastime has to be performed.
这个逍遥时光，这个lila必须这样。
Lord Rama has to go to the forest. He has to kill all these rakshasas who are there in the forest.
主Rama必须到森林里面去杀掉这些恶魔。 所有的一切都是在安排之中的。
We shouldn't try to adjust everything just for our own sake.
我们不要去尝试着试图去调整一些东西为了我们自己的原因。
Just like the Christians say, Jesus died for our sins, so I can do whatever sin I like.
这个就像基督教里面，这个耶稣基督啊，他 承担了我们的所有的业报，所以我们可以做一切事情。
We can do any nonsense we like.
我们可以胡作非为的自己想怎么做怎么做。
And Jesus already took the karma.
因为这个基督啊，已经带走了我们的业报。
So sometimes we could think like that, you know. Krishna says, "Give up all religious principles."
有些时候我们也会利用 Krishna 说放弃一切宗教,
so I can do anything I like.
所以我可以做一切事情,
and Krishna will protect me.
Krishna 会保护,
I've surrendered to Krishna.
我是臣服 Krishna.
We can't cheat.
我们不能欺骗, 自我欺骗,
we have to follow the principles.
我们应该遵守这些原则。
So, truthfulness is important.
说真话是很重要的。Okay,
any other question?
好，还有问题吗？
Yes, Vaishnavi, Hare Krishna, welcome.
So can we buy cow's milk or not from shops? Can we buy cow's milk or how we should do now? We cannot
Can we buy cow's milk from the shop?
那到底我们应该不应该在这个店里面去买牛奶呢？
Well, when Prabhupada went to America,
当帕帕去美国的时候,
we were certainly using the milk, purchasing the milk.
我们当然那个时候就开始买牛奶了。
Prabhupada never said don't use the milk.
帕帕从来没有说不要用这些牛奶。
No, we used it.
我们用了。
And we were taught very important. We take a glass of milk every night.
我们每天都喝牛奶。
And Prabhupada taught making sweet rice with the milk, you know, many milk sweets.
然后帕帕当时告诉我们如何做这些甜点，牛奶的甜点。
But he also taught us.
但是他同时告诉我们。
That it's good to have our own cows.
告诉我们我们应该有我们自己的。
And then we can have our own milk.
然后呢，我们就有自己的牛奶了。
This milk which you get, which they have in the shops, is commercial thing. It's not the real thing.
这个在商店里面的这个牛奶呢，它是非常罪恶的，也不是真的，不是真的牛奶。
We want to try to arrange to have more of our own.
我们试着，我们应该试着安排我们自己的这个牛奶，更多的一些其他的事情。Even
our own grains, we should grow Prabhupada said.
即便我们的这些谷物都是 ，even our
we should grow our own.
Prabhupada 说，即便我们的这些谷物应该也是自己种，自己种大米。
We get grains, you know, it's all so many chemicals and things.
我们现在吃的这些大米也有很多的农药。
She goes to her daughter. They said this some of the milk are camel's milk.
Yeah, she took some camel's milk. not pure cow's milk, but some camel's milk mixed in. Definitely in India it's common buffalo milk. Because the buffaloes, they don't get so sick, they're not so easy, they're not so vulnerable, they don't become sick as easily as the cow. And the buffalo milk is more thicker than the cow's milk.
Buffalo, what's the name?
水牛，他说，就是我们的这个有一些文达姆的这个牛奶，它是水牛的牛奶，它不容易生病，而且呢，比这个奶牛要好一些，但是牛奶品质并没有奶牛好。Prabhupada said, drink buffalo milk, you get buffalo brain.
但是呢，他的话呢说，如果你喝水牛的牛奶，你就会得到一个水牛的大脑袋。
水牛的智商。我想问一下，就是说，就是说，那么多人来喝这个牛奶，那一年的那个产量有多少？能供应上吗？She
said the milk is enough for all the human beings.
Yeah.
当然可以供应得上。 Because she said, human are huge people.
No, but there's a lot of cows.
但是也有很多的奶牛。
There's many cows in America and in South America, Australia. You ask, he's from Australia. There's so many cows there. One devotee I know, they were in Singapore and they moved to New Zealand, and the lady told me, she said, in our place in New Zealand, it's all cows, there's no people.
他说他的一个朋友去从新加坡到达了新西兰之后，新西兰的这个奉献者就说，那里全是奶牛，没有人。<laughs>
Many farms, the cows, famous New Zealand.
非常多的农场全都是奶牛，没有人。问题是我们离那里很遥远的嘛。
Instead of buying so many electronic and mechanical gadgets like cars and everything, we have money for cows.
Yeah.
他不说，就是我们可以用这个买车的钱，买这些东西的钱，可以用来存下来，用来保护奶牛。我说是的。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.